I'd like to talk about pitch. What pitch is, why it's important, does it really matter? And the answer, short answer really, is that the pitch within reason doesn't matter so long as it's within certain ranges. What pitch is, it's the angle on the gate here. So this angle here. Now, normally you'd find that the oar has a flat piece here and that's on the same plane as the blade at the end. So that's vertical, that's vertical. Now, when the blade sits in the gate and it's held against the gate, as it would be if you were pulling on the handle, then the angle of the blade is set by what the gate's set at. Now, you can see here that the blade's got a small angle like that. If, for example, the blade was like that, then that's a very large angle, massive angle. If the blade's like that, then that's clearly going to cause us a problem, because as soon as you pull on the handle, the blade's going to want to go straight down into the water and you'll catch a crab. So pitch is really important, particularly if it's wrong. If it's okay, then it's usually okay. If you're a very experienced oarsman, you can tell small differences in pitch because the feel of the boat is different. If you have a boat where the angle of the pitch is set incorrectly and it's got some blades in the boat that are on an angle like that, then you'll find that the boat's very unbalanced because it's very difficult to row a boat with a pitch like that. You also find that some of the athletes are likely to get crabs. If, conversely, it's got too much pitch, then it doesn't really cause that massive a problem. It's harder to hold the oar in the water, as you can see from that angle, but it's not likely to, so it'll upset the balance of the boat, but it's not likely to cause a crab, of course. So, pitch. If you at the catch position we are here, then we tend to want to have somewhere between 3 to 5 degrees of pitch, so an angle there. As it comes through to the finish, then we tend to have less pitch at the finish. But we want to make sure that we never have negative pitch, because we have that same issue that you're going to end up catching a crab, upsetting the balance of the boat, and clearly not a good issue. So the way to check the pitch, there's a number of complex ways you can do it, or we've got a very simple way to check it as well. So in order to make sure that the blade's set up correctly in itself, then when you get a new set of blades, I suggest check them once. Not that you get many that are wrong, but occasionally it can happen. And if the sleeve here is positioned incorrectly on the shaft in relation to the blade, then you'll find that there's something that needs to be adjusted and moved. So you'd undo the sleeve and adjust it correctly. If you find a sleeve that you think's moved, then use this method to check it. It's a good, easy check, and then fix the sleeve so that it matches. The easy way to check is to take the blade and put the blade on the edge of the boat, making sure that the boat's level, pretty much level in this direction. Then put the blade on and put the blade so that it's perpendicular to the boat and that it's about there on the blade. Not right on the end, but in a fraction. Then all you need to do is to check against on the collar here, and you can see that we end up very close to what we are here. Now, it's an imprecise measure because the blades have differences, lots of blades have differences here. So it's really about just checking, is the blade approximately right? So if you find that your blade, if you suspect that the blade might be wrong, then a very simple measure is to check it like this. So now we understand what pitch is about and why it's important. If the boat, you want to check it on the boat, then you can get the boat on a set of trestles like this and support it so that it's not going to rock around. Check that the boat's level across the deck like so, and then hold it in that position. So put some supports on each side and check that it's level this other direction. So if the boat's level, then it's quite easy to check the pitch on the pin. The pitch gauge like this, and you just hold it in there and see what number you come up with. Now, if we want to measure what the pitch is at the catch, then we'd come around this way, and we've got a certain number of degrees there, and round to the finish, and we come around here and we find that it's slightly less. Now, the problem with checking the pitch on a boat like this is that you need to make sure that it's very stable when you're checking it. And indeed, if you're going to adjust the pitch and take the pins out and bend them, or put different washers in the top or bottom to change the pitch, then you'd want to do it with the boat out on a set of trestles and set up correctly. However, most of you will find that pitches don't need to get changed, and all you really want to do is to check if they're okay. And the easy way to do that is to do it in the shed. So let's do it in the shed. Often we find in a club environment or a school environment that the pitch on some of the boats might be out because someone's hit a rigger, hit it on something hard, or they put it on incorrectly, something like that. Now, the problem with the pitch being out is if the pitch is out by a reasonable amount, then you'll find that when the athletes are rowing, the pitch will tend to push the oar deeper into the water, so they tend to catch more crabs. So if you imagine the oar going in, it's meant to be on an angle like that, so when you push it, you're pushing down into the water, whereas if the pitch is severely wrong and it's got that angle, then they pull on the oar, you'll find that it tries to go straight to the bottom, and so they'll catch a crab and upsetting the boat. If you've got different pitches in the one boat, then you're going to get different balance issues, and maybe some people will catch a crab. To check the pitch, a number of ways you can do it. If you take the boat out and put it on the level and up the right way and check it with a pitch gauge, then that's one way you can do it, but it takes longer. It's often a lot easier to do it in the shed. So here we are in the shed with this 8, and so long as the boat is level this way, so here's my pitch gauge, and as you can see, the boat's pretty well level down the boat. So then all I need to do to check the pitch is to grab the gate and sit it there, and I can see that that's 4.5. This one here, I can see that it's 3 and a bit. This one here is about 4. This one's about 4. This one's about 4. And so it's a really easy way to check the boat. And if the rigger in the 2-seat up the top there, you can see that had a little bit more pitch than the others. But the reality is 4.5, 5, 3.5, no one's really going to notice that unless they're a top-level athlete. And so it's a really simple way to check the pitch whilst you're in the shed. Now let's have a look and see what it looks like when one's wrong. Here we have a boat that I've made so that it's wrong. And if you check the pitch on this one, it comes in at about 1 to 2. Now, the problem with that is that that's too close for comfort. And so you'd want to check that, take that off and check it to make sure that it's right. So that's checking the base pitch. If your boat's level enough, then you can do more than that. If we check this, we can see that this... Are they all padded here? So you can check that. You can see that the bar that the boat's sitting on is level. Now, if the boat's sitting on it firmly, then that also means that you can actually check what the gate's doing from catch through to finish. So if we come through to the catch here, we can see that we've got about 4.5. And if we run it round to the finish, we can see it stays at 4.5 or maybe a fraction less. What that means is that the pin's pretty much vertical in both directions. Now, if you found one where the pin, where you started here and it said 5 and the boat was level and you came round to here and all of a sudden it was down about 1, then I'd suggest that you've got the pin is got a layout problem and you should take it off and fix it. So essentially what it means is that instead of having to have the boat out on trestles with sticks holding it so that it's in a firm position and it's all level both ways, often you'll find that these racks are level both that way and the rack will be level that way because that's generally how they're built. All you're really doing is just checking the boat while it's upside down. A much easier way to check. Be careful though. In a situation where the boat's sitting on a rack like this, then there's no real certainty that the boat's going to be level. And so it really only applies when you've got a firm rack and the boat's level. And it's quite easy to check if the boat's level. You can check the bottom of the boat and see if it's level. And you can even check the hull inside, the deck inside, if you wanted to make sure that it's level, and then check the pitches. Much, much easier to check the boat whilst they're in the shed, because as you can see how quick it is, it'll be quite easy to check all of the boats in the shed. It'll only take you a few minutes, and then you know that there's no serious issues. A really simple way to check the boat shed, check all the boats, so that then you know that the athletes are going to go out and have a good row in relation to pitch.